Hello. My name is Ken Gentry. I have a PhD in biomedical engineering, and I currently work for the Materials Research, Science, and Engineering Center at the University of Wisconsin. Today I'll be talking about Nature, the first nanotechnologist. Nature has been rearranging atoms and molecules on the inside of cells for billions of years. And these cells are on the order of micrometers, but the molecular machinery on the inside of cells is on the nanoscale. To help us start thinking about nature and nanotechnology, we can perform a short experiment in which oil and water are poured into a beaker. As you can see, the oil and water don't mix. The oil goes to the top and the water to the bottom. Water is a polar molecule, meaning there's an uneven distribution of electric charge in the molecule, whereas oil is a nonpolar molecule. Two polar liquids will mix, and two nonpolar liquids will mix, but a polar and a nonpolar liquid just won't mix, as our experiment has shown us. Lipids are a class of molecule commonly found in nature. Body fat is an example of a lipid. The lipid shown here is interesting because it has a polar head, shown in yellow, and nonpolar tails. The polar head is similar to water, while the nonpolar tails are similar to oil. So what would happen if some of these molecules were dispersed in water? Would they mix or not? Well, in a process called self-assembly, the lipid molecules will take the shape shown. On the left, you see what's known as a lipid micelle, in which all the nonpolar tails of the lipid molecules are facing inwards, and the polar heads face outwards. As more lipid molecules are added, a lipid bilayer, shown on the right, is formed. The polar heads of the lipid molecules face outwards, again, while the nonpolar tails face inwards. What does this have to do with nature? Well, the cell membranes of all your cells are made up of lipid bilayers, approximately 10 nanometers thick. The inside and outside of cells are mostly water, so the polar heads of these lipid molecules face outwards and into the cell, and the nonpolar tails form the inside of the lipid bilayer. In this picture, you can also see proteins embedded in the lipid bilayer membrane, globular red proteins and yellow helical proteins. These proteins sense the cell surroundings and also allow molecules to pass into and out of the cell. One interesting type of cell is called an olfactory receptor neuron. A neuron is a cell which is used to sense the surroundings, for example, hot or cold or wet or dry. This particular type of neuron senses odors. This picture shows the tip of a fly antenna, and there are a bunch of olfactory receptor neurons shown in green with dendrites shown in red that extend out into the environment. And these dendrites are actually what sense odors. Embedded in the lipid bilayer membranes of these dendrites are what are known as odor receptor proteins. I've shown an odor receptor protein in blue here, and it has a cutout of the shape of the letter R in it. So this protein will only respond to molecules shaped like the letter R. If a molecule shaped like the letter R comes by this particular neuron, a signal will be sent to the fly's brain. Many odors are composed of many different types of molecules. I've shown the scent from a rose here as being made up of R, O, S, and E-shaped molecules. So we need four different types of odor receptor proteins with R, O, S, and E-shaped indentations. So even though a fly has only 40 types of odor receptor neurons, it can sense thousands of smells because of different combinations of odor receptor proteins sensing different molecules. All of your body's activities in the cells, including sense of smell, movement, thinking, need to be fueled. And the mitochondria inside every cell produce fuel for the cell. On the left, you can see a picture of two mitochondria. They're about 1 micrometer long and 500 nanometers in diameter. And on the right, you can see a cutaway view of the mitochondria. The mitochondria have an external membrane, also a lipid bilayer, but also an inner membrane, which is a lipid bilayer, with many different folds in it. Embedded in the inner membrane are many interesting proteins which produce the fuel, particularly ATP synthase. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate. When a cell needs energy, it breaks off a phosphate group, shown in red, leaving adenosine diphosphate. A lot of energy is produced by this reaction, which the cell can use for its activities. The job of mitochondria is to turn ADP back into ATP so your body can keep moving, you can keep smelling things. Mitochondria produce ATP using an enzyme called ATP synthase. It's kind of a complicated enzyme, and we'll try to explain it. On one side of the inner membrane of the mitochondria, there are a lot of protons, and they want to move to the other side of the lipid bilayer membrane. They do so by moving through the red structure labeled C, and they cause it to rotate. As it rotates, so does the yellow protein labeled gamma that is attached to it. Gamma rotates, changing the shape of the blue and purple proteins, and this is how ADP is turned into ATP. ATP synthase is about 20 nanometers long and 9 nanometers in diameter, and in the next slide, we'll look at just the top half. Here, the rotor, gamma, is shown in gray and blue, and as it rotates, it is changing the shape of the surrounding proteins. And as they change shape, ADP is converted into ATP so that your body can continue its activities. Without the ATP synthase motor, you would quickly run out of ATP, which is the fuel for all your cells, and you wouldn't be able to move or smell or think. Scientists have studied ATP synthase by attaching small filaments or beads to the rotor and taking pictures of it rotate with special microscopes. Doing so, they've found that it rotates at up to 100 times per second. Today I've described just a few types of the molecular machinery inside all of your cells. There are many more, and scientists are discovering more all the time. They hope to use this knowledge to improve all of our lives. For more information on nanotechnology, please visit this website.